Well, but like everybody going crazy out there. Gotta be scared.
Well, I will tell you that you should wear a mask.
Blue
on the inside.
They said the mask is not.
Hard work.
There you go.
Hard work.
Everybody doing it right.
Hard work.
So I wanted to come on today and talk to you all about something that's a little more serious and something that's actually kind of trending right now in the news. And I know that it maybe, possibly, potentially could affect all of us here in the United States. I am stationed here in the United States. I'm an active duty U.S. Army soldier for those of y'all who are watching me for the very first time. I've been kind of tracking the coronavirus a little bit, especially since for me and for my viewers who have watched me for a while now, you all know I did leave the country at the beginning of the year. We went on a cruise for New Year, and so just been tracking it and learning a little bit more about it. And as I'm tracking it and as I'm watching it, I got to thinking about how this could potentially affect the military. My channel is geared towards people that are in the military, families that are in the military, and I strive to help put out helpful information for people that are joining and people that are already in. And so for the people that are thinking about joining, I just want to put out a little bit of information, because people don't realize how things like this could potentially possibly affect us U.S. active duty service members, regardless of the branch that you're thinking about joining. A lot of times we are the first responders to these type of things. If you take a look at all of those little zombie movies, and because I'm into Walking Dead and Z Nation and all of that, you see like people go to the CDC and people go to the military bases for relief, and you see the first people that are affected by the diseases are like the active duty people, the soldiers that are on the tankers, and they walk around like zombies. And I don't say this to scare you all, I just want people to know, and this is like, of course, extreme worst case scenario. I'm not hoping that it is Armageddon or anything like that, but it just got me to thinking, because I want people to know and realize some of the sacrifices that they're signing themselves up for. I signed my right hand and I swore to defend, you know, everybody here abroad and stateside. And so these are some of the sacrifices that the military in general take on. And I just want you all to keep that in the back of your mind, that everybody is affected. But if you're thinking about joining the military, I'm by no means saying don't join. I just want you to know what some of the possibilities that we are the first responders. And so when I put out videos like the trending videos, like I had I got a lot of views on my U.S. soldiers getting deployed and the memes and stuff like that. That's why I'm so passionate about it, because people don't realize the sacrifice that we put in and the sacrifice that the military and people as a whole are making every single day when they sign their right hand to swear and defend the United States and the service members and people that are here and people that are, you know, making light of the situation. And so please go back and watch that video. I'm going to link it here at the top, and I'll also link it down at the bottom. I just want you all to realize the magnitude of how things like this, something small like the coronavirus, could possibly affect the United States. There's already been at least 5 confirmed cases of people with the virus here in the United States, and people are traveling every day. People are moving and PCSing every day, and that's another way that it could affect the military. What if somebody was going over to Asia? I have friends right now, like besties right now, that are in Korea. More than one of my best military, I consider them family, that are over there in Korea. And there's confirmed cases in Korea. There's confirmed cases in Germany. I was stationed in Germany. I have friends that are right now in Germany. So it could affect people that are PCSing every day. It could affect your family members. What if somebody's bringing their family over there to live with them in Korea, and the virus breaks out? Right now, I know a lot of people are joining. It's the beginning of the year, and that's usually like a big cycle for people to join the military. People are at MEPS right now. People are picking their jobs right now. Right now, 68 Whiskey is a high priority MOS. They need medics. If you don't know, a 68 Whiskey is a combat medic. And so bonuses are high right now. They are needing medics. But guess who's going to be the first responders if something pop off? The medical personnel, like myself. This patch right here says that I am medical personnel. Now, although I'm not a 68 whiskey, I'm not a combat medic, I am a pharmacy technician, and people gonna need their medicine. They gonna need their flu shots. They gonna need their coronavirus shots. So everybody in the medical field could potentially be affected, because we're gonna be the first responders that have to respond with medicine. They're gonna have to respond with medical care. People that are lab techs gonna have to draw blood. People that are radiology techs gonna have to take x-rays. People that are OR techs might have to perform surgery. So any of the 68 series that is the medical series right now could be affected. And they're gonna be, they may be increasing the bonuses and increasing the amount of slots for those people, because we may or may not be at war. We may or may not be affected by the coronavirus. So this coronavirus is a trickle-down effect. Even though it may not be something as deadly and fatal right now, people that are higher up are watching it, and they're making plans for the worst. So I just say all that to say that I want you all during this time to keep your military personnel in mind, to pray for them, say a prayer for them. And I'm not saying that people are affected and the military is going to be called up tomorrow. It was placed on my heart to make this video because people don't understand the second and third order effects of something like this. Something so small, by some virus breaking out somewhere over in China, is going to affect everybody. Like I said, there are confirmed cases here in the U.S. There are confirmed cases in Korea, confirmed cases in Germany, and there's fear of it spreading. Now, right now, I hear that it's not considered fatal or deadly. It's not something that we need to like start going into hiding about or anything like that, but it's not fatal or deadly, and it's not something that we need to start like panicking about, because as of right now it's under control. But I know you all have heard about the Americans that were brought over here on a charter jet to a military base. As I said, military is the first responders, and they have those people under 72-hour watch right now, just to monitor them to make sure that they don't have it and they don't potentially infect more people in the U.S. So I say all that to say that military, we go through a lot. We sign up for a lot. We put ourselves through a lot, but it's really what I signed up for. And I want people to know that when they're going into MEPS, or if they're in the military or they're thinking about joining, it's bigger than yourself. And that's the biggest thing that I get out of the military, and I try to preach to help you be the best soldier you can be and to be informed that being in the military, you are a part of something way bigger than yourself. I want you all to take it with pride. I want you to be prideful and proud of this, because you could potentially be helping out my peoples, my family and friends over there in Korea. So that's it, guys. Make sure you go ahead and check out my playlist below. I have lots of valuable information out there, and if you found this one helpful, definitely share this video and click the like button, and let me know down in the comment section what you're thinking about the coronavirus. I'll see you all in the next one. Bye.